I remember my grandmother saying to me, I don't care what they tell you in school.
Now, I don't care what they tell you in school. Romans wore leather armor. So, Netflix, Cleopatra. I guess a lot of us have seen this show up in our YouTube feeds, Facebook, and so on, to the death for past few weeks. And today was actually a premiere of the series, of the docudrama series produced by Jada Pinkett-Smith. I'm not going to do the full review of the show, at least not for now, because this is a big topic. But what I can do now is a review of costumes, mainly armors, that we could see with our own eyes in the show. And was it good or bad? Like, I mean, it was pure garbage, I won't lie. Like, imagine every single movie trope about Romans and how they looked like, and just turn to 11. Like, oh my god, like, it's just bad. But let's just dive in and see what exactly is wrong, and maybe if they even did something right-ish. We'll see. I've divided actually to four parts. Mainly bracers, body armor, helmets, and shields, with a short bonus round with a few extra stuff at the end. Let's begin. So, bracers. Lovely, lovely bracers. In terms of showing Romans in movies or TV shows, bracers or leather armbands are like a classic trope. They're like Roman equivalent of Viking horned helmets, meaning people associate it with them, but nobody can really justify it. Although even for Vikings it might be even more justified than it is for Romans. But why I have this specific issue? Well, in the show, pretty much every Roman soldier is using them, or like Roman generals too. And why it bothers me? Because there is no archaeological evidence or written evidence for that type of equipment being used in the era. But Camille, you could say that because they are made of leather, they would not survive to our times. So we have no evidence that they didn't exist. Well, fair point to you, but honestly, no. We do have actual evidence of Romans using arm protection, and it wasn't like a small leather armband. It was called a manica, and it was a form of arm guard that was used both by Roman legionaries and gladiators, although it varied between them. In terms of Roman army, manica was armor similar to what cataphracts would use. So it was segmented arm guard that would cover your sword arm. And I mean, it offered pretty solid protection, although it wasn't yet in use in the period of the show. And when it comes to gladiators, they use a lot of forms of arm protection, but they were either cloth, like a thick cloth, or, like in case of legionaries, segmented arm guard, sometimes even scale arm guards. I really don't get the love for leather bracers in Roman-esque shows and movies. People often make a point about budget constraints when it comes to costumes and armors in historical movies. And they say, okay, but you have those extras and actors, you need to put something on them, you can't, you know, go over the budget. Fair concern. Yes, this is a very valid point. But why then you add leather bracers that were not used? So actually, you know, you take extra steps to add something that didn't exist and you hurt your budget with it. So screw them. Honestly, just get rid of them. But are any bracers justified? The typical movie bracer is just a short arm band, like leather armband, and that type would be, for example, good for archers and anyone who did archery, like I do archery for like past 20 years of my life. And honestly, when it comes to historical bows, I can't imagine not using a bracer, at least having a fixed sleeve on my bow arm, otherwise it's going to be a pretty bad rash. Granted, even when it comes to archers depicted on Roman art, we don't see any bracers, so take it as you will. Now, let's move to body armor. Usual movie trope when it comes to Romans is to show them wearing leather segmentata or leather masculata armor. And in here we have a leather galore. Basically, everyone is wearing a different type of leather masculata, and it's just garbage. But what armor would have been appropriate instead? Simple mail armor, just give them mail. It's the most common armor of the era when it comes to Romans. And the thing is, mail is cheap. Like when it comes to production of this size, it's a minuscule cost. But even if, you know, taking budget issues into account, like you could have just rented a few of them or maybe order five mails, like prop mails. They are very cheap, very cheap. And you can easily order them from any place in the world, pretty much. And because this production has few extras, it would not have been an issue if you just, you know, in one scene, guy A wears mail armor, and then in other scene, guy B wears it. Because there are like five extras in this, so what's the issue? And when it comes to more prominent characters, like Mark Antony or Octavian, you could have just order iron masculatas or like even aluminum ones. Basically, whatever is cheap, available, and sort of does not look like garbage. Because, oh my god, we'll see in a few seconds. The armors we got in the show are bad. There's like no other way around it. They're like Witcher's Nilfgaard scrotum armor level of bad. Thank you Netflix again for this one too. And especially, like, take a look at Octavian. Like, what is this supposed to be? Like, what armor is it supposed to be? I think they were going for, like, a phyra, which is, like, a medal that Romans wore on top of their armor. But I'm not even sure. Like, I'm not even sure if people that came up with these costumes knew what phyra is. So probably they just stumbled on this armor in some movie prop vault and just thought, okay, let's take this for one of the most powerful and rich guys on the world during that time. Now, chapter 3, helmets. Probably the best part when it comes to equipment in the show. Again, they are not correct. They are actually Imperial Gallic type helmets, or at least they are supposed to be them, because they are not quite well made. They look very cheap and sort of cobbled together. But again, yeah, they are like Roman helmets ish from at least century later, which is not that bad, like being a century off. I mean, it's an issue, it's a mistake, but it's not the worst one to make. And how you can spot it? Well, because you have this distinct Roman neck guard behind the helmets, which was not yet in use during Cleopatra's time. As a side note, and actually a good thing, at least their cheek guards are strapped, which is not that common. Like, take a look at many movies, video games, like the cheek guards are just loosely hanging, which sort of defeats the point of cheek guards. Finally, let's take a look at the shields, and it's something, because oh my god, like honestly, I can only laugh at them, because they look like something you bought from like a gift shop with just plastic crap next to a Colosseum in Rome. I have no words on it. Like, take a look at them. Like, take a good look at this abomination, because oh, it's bad. And wait a second. Just hold on for a minute. Like, aren't they familiar? Because yes, they are. They are probably from some heavily guarded Hollywood vault, because they seem to show up from time to time in different movies and media, including latest Ben-Hur and even HBO's Rome. They like, even though the show usually had good shields, like you can see this type of shields in a few shots too. Now in this short scene, you can actually see a lot better looking Roman shields. Unfortunately, again, wrong period. Like, even though this is like probably the most recognizable Roman shield shape, it's not the one that would be in use during Cleopatra's time, as at that time Romans would have used a bit more oval shields. Although, again, at least these shields look fine when it comes to quality. Like, they look very good. So, again, wrong period, but at least good quality. Let's begin our bonus round. So, let's take a look at enemies of Rome in the show. Parthians. They only show up for a short time, as sort of like a speed bump in Mark Antony's arc. And what they are supposed to be like. Take a look at this dude. Like, take a look at this dude. Like, what is he supposed to be? Again, that armor you might recognize from garbage Spike TV series on King Tut. Not recommended. And what sword is he using? Oh, it's a Roman gladius. No, like, I get that they might not have a budget to show an actual Parthian mail-clad cavalry. Cataphracts, they like distinct cataphracts in the show. Okay, fine. But if you go for infantry, let's just show normal infantry. Like, it wouldn't be even armored, so you don't really need to put money into it. Just make him look fine and not the way he looks here. Now, the armor that our Parthian guy was using is also reused for Egyptians in the show. And again, it's wrong, because we do know how Egyptian soldiers looked in the period, and they were pretty similar to how Romans looked like. So mail armor, scale armor, and so on. We have several depictions of them. A lot of them would have been Greek, because the Greeks made a lot of military colonies in Egypt and pretty much everywhere in post-Alexandrian empires. And yeah, this is how they are supposed to look, and not how they look in the show. Now, our final bonus. Crown of Egypt that Cleopatra is wearing in the show. It's not Egyptian crown. God damn it. Well, it looks like an Egyptian crown at a glance. It's an Egyptian crown, like it has the snake called Ureus on the forehead, in this case double Ureus. But what's the issue? Like, if you look at King Tut's mask, it has something similar, but take a closer look. It's actually not a double snake, just one snake, and the other animal is vulture. Ureus, the snake, was a symbol of divine authority in ancient Egypt. So the symbol itself is okay, it's just that double Ureus is not. And who used that crown? Kingdom of Kush, of course. And yeah, that's their crown. And we can see exact same crown used by 25th dynasty, the Black Pharaohs from Kush that conquered Egypt. They were using it. Not Ptolemaic Egyptians, and not Egyptian Egyptians, I would say it. But yeah, well done, like, great job. And that would be it for my review of Netflix Cleopatra's historical accuracy when it comes to equipment depicted in the show. And as a final rating, I give it a solid James Corden out of 10. Do you agree with my assessment? Maybe I missed something or I was wrong. If so, go to the comment section and please let me know. And I hope to see you in my next video. This time, we'll give Cleopatra some time to heal and we'll look at Khmer battle elephants. See ya!